In Africa, art is a question of survival. It takes a genius to keep moving forward without giving in to desperation and to keep smiling. Seen in this way, every African is an artist. African artists have always had a perspective and language of their own. History and literature, until colonization, were never written. They were always oral. The plastic arts were anonymous. Painting, almost always symbolic, played with forms until they became unrecognizable. Theater, dance, music, all the arts have been present in Africa, but none has remained for long. Africa is an expert in the art of the ephemeral.
We have rap to express ourselves, to say what we think, what we feel, how we feel it, how we think things should be. If we have a problem, rap is our solution, because we're the voice of the people. We represent them. Rap is like a tool.
Witness and water make up the group Wagoble, one of the latest sensations on the Senegalese music scene. Both live in the depressed outskirts of Dakar. Their lyrics come straight from life in their neighborhood.
We rebel through our lyrics. This is our vehicle for rebellion. This has nothing to do with using violence to create or to solve problems. Yeah, in fact, rap is there to criticize. It's something that goes against the system. People think that Wagoble is an English word, but it's not. It's a Wolof name. In our language, Wa means to come from, and Goble means ghetto, outskirts. Wagoble is good and bad, black and white. It's everything. It's an example of how the world works today. The whole world is a Goble. There are continents, races, and people living side by side who are incredibly rich and extremely poor. It's a melting pot, and that's what a Goble is. Good and bad are within us. Each of us has goodness and badness inside. It's the same in the Goble. In the neighborhood, you see a kid who is doing well, you see people moving about, everything is the duality of life that's within each of us. It's the Goble, the outskirts, the ghetto. There are ghettos everywhere, everywhere in the world. We represent what comes from the ghetto.
Live for the government, live for the money, live for the business, business, business. yup, yup, sir, yup, yup.
Live for the government, live for the money, live for the business, live for the business,
hey,
business,
aye.
Business.
Aye, 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 God of day.
In Senegal, rap has represented a true cultural revolution in recent years. The young people of Senegal have found in hip-hop culture a way to rebel against social injustice. Their lyrics speak of the problems with education or public transportation, of the lack of opportunities and political corruption. And this is not mere artifice. They have real power. In the elections held in April of 2002, rap groups, with their lyrics, decided to boycott the government, and they succeeded. The young artists of Dakar, using their lyrics and their vote, achieved a change of government.
Okay.
Alif is another new face on the Senegalese cultural scene. This group, made up of three women, confronts the problems suffered by women in their country. They were the first female rap group to be formed in West Africa. They are now recording their first album.
Thanks to music, we can show women the right path to follow. Because women have always believed that they should stay behind, stay at home, cook, do the washing. We want to show them that they can liberate themselves, that they can be company leaders, that they can think just like men. Alif means liberation attack of the women's infantry. What we're trying to say is that we are an armada, an army created to defend women, one that can transmit their ideas. But the situation for women has changed a lot since our parents' day. Now we see women in the government. There are female ministers. There are women in every sector. At first I liked jazz. I like jazz a lot. And reggae and rap as well. It's what drove me to make music with my group. Rap wasn't created to please people, but to condemn the wrongs of society. There are things I don't like here, and I wanted to say what they were, to say stop. When I see big artists on TV, it excites me. Drives me to work hard so we can become like Michael Jackson or Whitney Houston. Why not? I believe in the music we make, and I'm sure at some point in their lives, they had the same dream I do.
Gore Island is very important to us. It reminds us of our history because, as everyone knows, here we experienced the horror of slavery. Slaves from all over Africa were here. It was the last bit of African soil they would ever touch. So this soil, this land, we can't forget it. We are this land. We are Africa.
En ce moment, il y a beaucoup de choses qui se sont dissipées un peu avec le temps.
Today, you find that many things have disappeared with time. But when we come here, we walk around and we see the traces that remain, and we remember how horrible it was. We're here to overcome that fear inside us, fear born out of the oppression we have suffered. And in this way, we feel stronger for the future.
The Baifal live on Gore Island. They are an Islamic sect, pacifists and mystics. Both water and witness share their philosophy.
The Baifal live on Gore Island. They are an Islamic sect, pacifists and mystics. Both water and witness share their philosophy. Baifal is the simplest, most natural way for an individual to live in peace in the world, with all that happens around you. A Baifal is the most peaceful person, one who never criticizes, who keeps his distance, a philosophical person. Everything is part of Baifal wisdom. We can't say we've achieved this, because that is the wisdom, the extreme wisdom of each individual. Each Baifal teaches you how to live, to integrate yourself into society, to live side by side with other people, regardless of race, nationality, or religion.
Fight and Forget isn't so much a rap group as a cultural experiment and a record label. They are independent musicians who belong to different bands and who get together on a regular basis to rap. A common theme in their music is the condemnation of social injustice.
Hypocrisy was widespread in the country. We rappers have gotten rid of hypocrisy. We have denounced the wrongs in society. For us, the country's development is at stake. We speak out so that young people can change.
Avec nos dirigeants, ils ont été influencés par les.
Our leaders were influenced by white people. All we can do is criticize, speak out about what's happening. We say it out loud, very loud, what others won't even whisper. That's our role.
Les rappeurs ont joué un rôle non négligeable, tu vois.
Our role as rappers has been a commendable one because we were the first to take a risk and say to people that we've had enough, that we need something else, a different political system. In the government, they're all corrupt. Senegal itself is corrupt. There's only hypocrisy. The problem is corruption. They take the people's money for themselves. You white people, do you know what our lives are like here in Africa? Africa's not rubbish. It's not rubbish. I'm 28. I can't even manage to feed myself or eat until I'm full. 90% of Senegalese people are like me. It's a catastrophe, a holocaust, the apocalypse. That is politics. Screw them.
Fight and Forget, Wagoli, and Alif meet in the recording studio in Dakar to record a jam session. Bob Dina suggests a musical theme, and then each artist improvises lyrics on that theme. The lyrics will be used together to make the final song.
Mic XL, not the one that's tell, so brand first tell, not the sound that felt brown, mix L, yeah, walk up, down.
La politique elle-même.
I don't like politics. It's all false, all short-lived. And it's the same everywhere, the same people. Bush, Jacques Chirac, Blair, they're all the same, everywhere. We are here and we're against politics. What we're concerned about is the survival of the poor. We experience rap very differently from Americans. Here we live in peace, in solidarity. We live with our parents and evolve with them. Americans have problems with their parents, with life itself, because there everyone lives for himself or herself. Here it's not like that. Rap is not something artificial, something you buy and sell. You feel it directly, from person to person. If words aren't enough, we'll try to find another medium. But for the moment, words are our only means of expression, through rap, hip-hop. The sculptor hits the chisel 10,000 times, 10,000 times to produce a shape. This means that sculpture is the most paroxysmal of all the arts.
Boubacar lives in Dakar. He's a Senegalese sculptor who works with stone and has established a school. His workshop has produced artists who have found success in both Europe and the United States.
Justement, dans la pierre, il y a un grand secret.
Stone hides a great secret.
C'est que la pierre constitue une prison.
The stone's secret is that it hides a prison created by God. Every prisoner needs to be freed. And God has chosen people like us to give them the key to their freedom. I am proud to be among the people who free up the ideas imprisoned in stone. This sculpture represents a family reunion from many years ago, from the time of our grandparents. Before, in Africa, each member of the family had a particular task. Children stayed at home while the adults went in search of food. This symbolizes a family reunion. There's the grandfather, the head of the family. He's the hunter. The women harvest crops and the men fish. Art is something profound. It involves looking at an object, finding something within it, and bringing out what you found. That's what art is.
At the other end of the continent, in South Africa, we find Willie Bester, an artist who recycles scrap metal to build his pieces. He is an artist committed to the history and the present of his country. Through his work, he attempts to speak about the horrors of apartheid. The very house in which he lives is a work of art. He has shaped it over time to form a sculpture.
I used to play a role of a watchdog, and artists should play that type of role, where you monitor the government of the day. And if they make any mistakes that look similar than the old ones, then you just keep them on their toes by producing art that they can see how they can sort of transform this country. I built heavy political sculptures sometimes, and then you sometimes need a break. And it was during that break that I did the saxophone player. Yeah, there's the AIDS, there's also people are very selfish, they throw away everything. So for me it's about recycling as well. I think it's a global issue here, because our biggest problem ahead will be the issue of water. For me it's much bigger than the apartheid system or any government system. The water is a very universal one, and I incorporated a lot of taps and valves into the house. Yeah, this chair is called poverty driven. It's driven by poverty. This can, you see the wheel can move. Yeah, and this is what is left after you serve in the workplace as a poor person. Yeah, this is the leftovers. No, it is a comfort which is created on the expense of the poor. That's why you see the spades was used by the poor in order to bring this new system, whatever.
I was silly for banana sample. I can't jamana monoma. Oh, hey, one bengajamana lali. Fembe kemekeme be masakeni bulu. Adumunyate. Ayaka jamana kono mogo ma. Oh, hey, one bengajamana lali. Fembe kemekeme be masakeni bulu. Adumunyate. Ayaka jamana kono mogo inara. Ke benara. Mimbra yele. Ube be. Kembra yele. Masakeni doku. Aye duku ke dalade. Kafo jelibai. Kasani dunenta. Kawadi dunenta. Mimbara uta moso. iye ko mo so le marama kudu ni ndi lubatedia misiba nono mana bi lubatedia malubakini mana bi lubatedia ne ejeli adege mba fe mba toko le ko kari
I'm a griot. I learned this trade when I was very young from my mother. She told me that we were the bearers of a great secret, that we were the keepers of tradition. That's why it's my duty to transmit this to my granddaughters.
Fanta Diabate is the most veteran of the women griots of Kela, in the heart of the Mandé, the most sacred area for the Mandingo people, the site where their culture was born. In the Mandé, as in the rest of traditional Africa, culture and oral tradition are one and the same. Fanta Diabate is the matron of a large family of 65 members, in which all, without exception, are griots. Her husband is Lasana Diabate, known as the Grand Griot of the Mandé.
A griot plays a very important role in our society. He or she is in charge of communicating all events, whether happy or sad. We are masters of words, and we are the keepers of history. This village is the center of our tradition, of all Mandé culture. They call on us from all over the region to ask one of us to attend weddings or celebrations, or to commemorate the heroic deeds of our ancestors.
In the center of the village of Kela stands the word tree. Every afternoon, the elders and the most influential men of the village meet there. They speak of relevant issues such as the annual millet harvest, inheritances, or the latest results of the Mali national football team.
As a griot, we can't build the body of instruments. The caste of smiths possesses that knowledge. Tradition tells us that if we want to have an instrument, we must bring the smith white coconut wood, some kola nuts, and a hen.
The blacksmiths are a separate caste, related by marriage to the griots through their noble ancestry. Mali became a modern state several decades ago, but its traditional power structure remains intact. The griots, together with the blacksmiths, are the soul and memory of the Mandé.
It's a question of honor, honor and tradition. My father was my guide, and I made many mistakes before I learned this trade. When my father is gone, I want to be the one to teach my children, because as the Bambara proverb says, if your father climbs a tree and you are unable to climb it, take shelter in its shade.
The Diabaté family has been invited to a baptism that is being held in the neighboring village, which is where they are headed.
Griots exist to testify to the fact that everything is happening as it should. We are here to exalt the nobles or to reproach them if they are not fulfilling their duties according to tradition, to make sure that a marriage does not transgress the caste system, or to liven up baptisms.
Fanta, as a keeper of tradition, is responsible for shaving the child, a symbol of his acceptance as a member of the community. The two children being baptized today are the heirs of a powerful family of nobles. During the ceremony, the guests offer money to the Diabaté family in recognition of their work. It is their payment. They praise the family's glorious past, and they know all of the family's history from generations long past. Feats in battle, the heroic way in which they amassed their wealth.
I don't think that radio or television will replace us, because only we know what deeds or events made our heroes great, and we know how to transmit that knowledge. Television doesn't know any of that. Young people who think being a griot is not interesting are lost. They don't know who they are. A griot should not only know history. My wife knows how to tell stories and sing, and my oldest son is learning how to play instruments.
If we know who we were in the past, we will understand who we are today. The young people I teach today must understand this so that the tradition never dies and so that our people continue to be important.
Jalia, Iyo jalia ala le da jalia da terna wuli
iyo jalia ala la ka jalia
just me sometimes sitting on the pavement. Just singing some song. Maybe sometimes when I'm hurt, just singing my songs. Maybe when my mother did something for me, fine, I just go and cry and cry. After crying, I just sing the song.
Raymond Bokwana began singing when he was 8 years old. His first performances were in the street, asking for coins from passersby. Later, he formed his own group with other street kids and invented opera marimba, performing such work as La Traviata, Tosca, and Amahl and the Night Visitors.
When you play marimba, most of the people need they're always like they're thinking of African music, like African music, all that stuff. But look what you do, you change it. That's why you can play like blues, opera, African music, jazz, whatever. Yeah, whatever thing can come in your mind, you can just play it and stuff. Even the djembas, you change the style of the djembas. Djembas always hitting with the hand. But now playing with the sticks and just do something unique. Yes, go like the creeper that like.
Sometimes I don't mind even to stay with other girlfriend. I don't mind. I've got my girlfriend as well to me, inside me. That's what music means to me. Yeah. That's why I love it. That's why I want to be, maybe for this, but maybe I'll be there. You know, sitting there and be like, hey, maybe sometimes you can just go down if you don't know. Yeah, it's quite good because sometimes it can be there. Music is my love. It's everything to me. It's my mom, it's my dad, it's my girlfriend.
His idea has been so successful that the group has already finished their first tour, which took them to Europe, China, and Singapore.
Sometimes God can be with me at the same time, always, as long as I'm praying for it. To get to be rich, but I don't want to be rich. I want to afford. You know, this person I want to afford, not to be rich. I want to be rich because when I'm rich, hey, no, no, I can't handle the money. Maybe for me, I want to buy a car, just buy a car. Maybe just want something. If maybe my mother want this, just go for this. Like, just want to afford. Don't want to be rich, don't want to be poor, but want to be there, that level.
When I decided to make films, I realized you needed to have a strong personality and you need to love the cinema. I thought wanting to be a filmmaker was just a question of deciding to do it, and that's what I did. I said to myself, why not? I'm going to make films too.
Oh, yeah,
Suzanne Kuruma is one of the few African directors who has been able to premiere her work. Mother Courage, her first feature-length film, is a documentary drama based on the true story of a woman suffering from AIDS who is fighting to survive. I'm very interested in the lives of women and children, and that's why I decided to focus my documentary on women. A courageous woman, a widow who lives with her three children, who struggles to educate, clothe, and feed them. At the same time, she's HIV positive and is also fighting to get well, to get the medicine she needs to keep living. The lead actress has AIDS, has children to feed, and despite this, she has to overcome this and struggle to survive. Coincidence or not, this film tells the story of her life. When she read the script, she asked me if I had met her before, or if someone had told me her story before, because everything in the script described what she had gone through. So when she played the role, she was playing herself.
Je suis une personne affectée par le VIH/SIDA.
I am a person living with AIDS. If I agreed to play this role, I did so to represent all of the HIV-positive people who, because they are marginalized by society, do not want their face to appear on screen.
Alice?
Oui, Sonia, qu'est-ce qui se passe?
Peux-tu m'aider avec un peu de ton sel?
Qu'est-ce que tu as préparé?
Du haricot.
J'espère que je serai invitée.
Pas de problème.
Mais qu'est-ce qui se passe?
Et vous là-bas, arrêtez! Vous le savez, c'est pas bon de se bagarrer.
C'est quoi? Hein? C'est quoi? Je t'ai pas dit de ne plus venir ici. Hein? Allez.
Burkina Faso, despite being one of the poorest countries on the continent, is at the forefront of film production. It has a film school where Suzanne Kuruma studied, and a National Center for Cinema, which is in charge of getting co-productions as well as promoting local directors.
Le matériel, c'est vrai. Il y a des maisons de production.
It's true that we have good film production in Burkina. But finding the equipment to film is not easy. Today, making a film is very difficult. It's an obstacle course, a real battle. In spite of the difficulties Suzanne points out, Burkina Faso is an exception within Africa, and its film festival is exceptional. Called FESPACO, it is the most important film festival held on the continent. Thanks to this festival, which takes place every 2 years, the finest African directors, screenwriters, and film composers have made a name for themselves.
My songs usually have a common theme, African women. My music speaks of the strength and courage of these women.
I don't consider myself a feminist, but I am in favor of women's liberation. Since entering the film profession, I believe that a woman can do everything a man can do. I feel that men and women complement each other. There are no bosses in our team. Rather, we all complement each other.
Work on a film under a woman director? Well, I think it's the same as working under a man. There's no difference.
Suzanne is a fighter, and she's a woman who, for a long time, has wanted to make films that serve to raise public awareness, especially with regard to the problems that affect African women. Working as a production manager on a film, as a woman, is very complicated, because in addition to managing the crew on set, you can't forget about your normal domestic activities. I decided to tackle the subject of AIDS, because it's a current issue. If we want to raise public awareness, it's essential that everyone contribute in his or her own way. I want to highlight this woman's courage, and I want people to understand that a person should not be marginalized and abandoned by their family simply because they are infected, especially when they have children to care for. I lost my husband and 3 young children to AIDS. I lost the middle child first, then the oldest, and finally the youngest. 7 years old, 3 years old, and 1.5 years. Among our people, we say that if a woman says that she is not a mother, it's because she hasn't tried hard enough to be one. As the saying goes, a picture is worth 1,000 words. This picture or image stays in people's memories. When they tell us that someone suffers from AIDS, it immediately puts us on our guard. AIDS is synonymous with death. We have to avoid this idea. We have to educate people so they will stop thinking that being infected is the same as having 1 foot in the grave. You can't change the world, but you can create a favorable environment in which to live your life.
Live for the government, live for the money, live for the business, live for the business, business, business. Live for the government, live for the money, live for the business, live for the business, hey, business, aye. Business.
Aye, 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 calote. Nilale si ble, tenin yo kwe kife, cause I'm a method man. Fanga fanga fala dofa, finga fanga dofa, fala, 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 fala. Like a music machine, cause I'm a method.
The mic XL, not the one that's tell. So brand first tell, not the sound that felt brown. Shh. Mixel, yeah, walk up, jam better. Rap, chow, tether, uptown, gather. Fucked up, dollar, walk up. I witness, yeah, yeah.
Les hommes se bouffent comme des loups. La situation devient de plus en plus chelou. À cause du hashish, les deals ne bloquent du tout. Même de hashish, on les développe, bloquent avec des sous.